radioactivity chapter, which is chapter 8 in your book. Now, radioactivity, the definition firstly, it's the spontaneous breaking up of unstable nuclei with the emission of one or more types of radiation. Now, it's only the elements with the radioactive symbol on the periodic table that are radioactive. Not all elements will emit radiation. Okay, so just bear that in mind. So, if the element has an unstable nucleus, it tries to stabilize itself by emitting one of three types of radiation. So the three types of radiation that you have to know about are alpha, beta and gamma. So I'm just going to talk to you about alpha radiation here now firstly. So you can see here that you've got an unstable nucleus. So something like, I was going to say americanum 241, okay? So if I just use that, so americanum 241, that's an unstable nucleus. Now just to revise for a second before we go any further, the bigger number, remember, is the mass number. The mass number is the number of protons and neutrons in the nucleus. This is only showing you the nucleus of the atom. It's not showing you the the outer electrons. So it's the red is the proton and the greens are the neutrons. So it's just showing you the nucleus. The mass, remember, mass number is the number of protons and neutrons. Why don't we include the number of electrons there? Because their mass is negligible. The atomic number tells you the number of just protons, remember. Okay, and remember we would have said that the atomic number was unique to an element. So if the atomic number changes, the identity of the element changes. Okay, now what happens here with alpha emission is the unstable nucleus emits two protons and two neutrons. Now that is essentially the same thing as a helium nucleus. Because if I was to draw out a nucleus of helium, this would be the nuclear formula that you'd find on the periodic table. Look, 4 and 2. So then if you're asked how many protons in the nucleus, you would say 2p because the atomic number is 2. How many neutrons? Well, 2 from 4 is 2. So that's the same thing as a nucleus of helium. An alpha particle, 2 protons, 2 neutrons, same thing as a helium nucleus, okay? Now, when the americanum 241, for instance, as an example, emits alpha, an alpha particle, well, what's happening to the mass number? Think about that now for a second. What would happen to the mass number of this nucleus here, okay, the mass of it, if it's giving off 2 protons and 2 neutrons? Well, the mass number would decrease by 4. So when you take 4 from 241, you're going to get 237, okay? So it's 1, 2, 3, 4 particles going from the nucleus, so it's decreasing by 4. Now, what would the atomic number decrease by? Now, what does atomic number mean again? Number of protons. So it's just the reds you're counting this time. So the atomic number is going to decrease by 2. And so the new atomic number is going to be 93. You must look up your periodic table then and find what element has an atomic number of 93. And when you do, you'll see that it's Np. And then to finish off that reaction there, you're just supposed to put the 4 and the 2 and the helium there, just so that when you add 237 and 4, you're getting your 241 back, and 93 and 4 get you back your 95. So that's what you would call a nuclear reaction. The changes are only taking place in the nucleus. There are no, I didn't mention electrons involved there, only nuclear changes. A new element is formed, okay? So you're going from americanum to Np. So new element and nuclear reaction, okay? Now, if I just move on there now, so for a second to the next, we now need to know properties of alpha particles, okay? Properties of alpha particles. So you can see there, firstly, they're telling you what are alpha particles. So alpha particles are 2 protons and 2 neutrons. Look, now, if you were asked in an exam question for two properties, you are not to say what it is. That's not a property of alpha particles. Like what it is it's 2 protons and 2 neutrons. You're not telling them a property there at all. So don't give that if that's the question. If you are asked for properties, you're going to say something like alpha particles are positively charged. Why are they positively charged? Because there are 2 protons and 2 neutrons. And remember, protons are positive. If they're positively charged, they'll be attracted to the negative electrode. They have the lowest penetrating power. So they are stopped by a thin sheet of paper. And an example, you need to know an example of an atom that would emit alpha, and americanum 241 is ours, and a use also. You need a use as well. Smoke, not fire, smoke. Okay, smoke detectors. Now, the next type of particle that might be emitted from an unstable nucleus is beta. So we've dealt with alpha, Now we're moving on to beta. Now with beta emission, what happens here? Again, it's changes that are occurring within the nucleus, okay? And you can see here, look, that what happens is that a neutron, which is, remember we said the neutrons were one of the greens, so this is like this neutron here, splits or changes to a proton and an electron. The electron flies out of the nucleus. Okay, so that flies out. So high-speed electron is essentially what the beta particle is. The proton stays. So it's important to remember there that the proton stays. So if we were going to do an example, carbon 14 is an example of an element that emits beta radiation. Okay, so if you look up at the periodic table, you can see the atomic number of carbon is 6. And carbon 14 then is the mass number is 14. Now, if that's going to emit beta radiation, you need to think about in your head, what does that actually mean? Now, remember that the neutron is changing to a proton. So you might initially think, oh, it's losing a neutron, so its mass number must decrease. But it's gaining a proton. So yes, it's losing a neutron, but it's gaining a red proton. So actually the mass will stay the same because the neutron it's losing is cancelled by the proton that it's gaining. Okay, now if the extra proton stays in the nucleus, what's happening to the atomic number, the number of protons? It must increase by 1. So it's going from 6 to 7. You then go to your periodic table and see what atom has an atomic number of 7. It's nitrogen. And then to complete your nuclear reaction, you have to put the E here for the electron. Electrons don't have any mass, so 0 up here, and they have a -1 charge. And you see what happens. Look, 14 plus 0 gives you back the 14. 7 minus 1 gives you back the 6. So that's what happens there when an unstable nucleus emits beta particles or beta radiation. Now, look at the properties of beta. Again, now, like I said to you in the last example, don't say what they are. So you're just going to say that you know, they, what are they? Well, they are high-speed electrons, okay? Negatively charged, because electrons are negatively charged. They're attracted to the positive electrode, okay? They have intermediate penetration power. An example would be carbon-14 and their use dating archaeological artifacts, so carbon-14 dating. Okay, now the last type of radiation then that we need to look at is gamma radiation. Now gamma radiation is electromagnetic radiation. So if it's a type of electromagnetic radiation, look, it moves like a wave. Remember, we would have said that. So radiation that moves like a wave. So it doesn't actually have a mass. It's not made up of particles as such. So it's electromagnetic radiation, no charge, is not affected or deflected in an electric field. Okay, very, very penetrating though. This is the most dangerous type of the three types of radiation that we've spoken about. It needs a thick block of lead to stop it. And an example would be cobalt-60, and the uses are there. Look, so if you've ever heard of anyone having radiation treatment for cancer and thing, then that's that would be gamma radiation that they would use for radiotherapy to preserve foodstuffs. So they use like spices and that, they would preserve those by passing gamma radiation through them. Or for sterilization of medical equipment, they use gamma radiation for that as well. Okay, now, finally, I just want to run through the differences now between chemical and nuclear reactions, okay? So chemical reactions will be the ones that you would have dealt with in second year. So they involve transfer of electrons or sharing of electrons. No new element is formed. You're just producing a compound. No release of nuclear radiation, and you're breaking bonds or you're forming bonds, chemical bonds, because it's involving electrons, okay? With nuclear reactions, the changes are, this is what we're just doing today. The changes are taking place in the nucleus, no electron involvement. You do form a new element because you're changing the atomic number. And if you change the atomic number, you will change the identity of the element. Radiation is released from the nucleus, no bond breaking or bond formation.